Hello friends, happy Thursday, welcome back to Puggsy. I was speculating in the last episode that I was almost done with the game, but I remembered that I still have the lighthouse to contend with, so let's check out the lighthouse. Looks like a dark house to me. LOL. Owned. Oh, this music's a jam. It's a bop. It's a Boppenheimer. Okay. Look at the little squid thing. Blob monster. I want one. Oh my god. I found where they make all the shoes. Shoes. Puggsy, I shoes you. Alright, Pelican. Better stay out of my way. Oh. Okay. What's all this stuff for? I remember something about placing items in one of these pots. I don't remember if that was this level or not. Huh. And I may be misremembering. Oh, this crustacean wants to bash my face in. Or maybe it's a mollusk. Oh, look at the moon. It's so pretty. And outer space. Oh, Puggsy. Maybe we'll get back to outer space one of these days. Ow. Ah, damn. Now I'll have to find another pair of shoes. Ah! Oh, rubber ducky. Come back to me. Stop being so shellfish. Owned. Okay. Well, the presence of the flashlight leads me to assume that there are other secrets to find. The rubber duck is off having an adventure. Yeah, don't worry about your ship for right now, Puggsy. You need to be looking for clues in this weird lighthouse. Oh. Okay. My god. Oh, we get a nice full view of the space background here. Psygnosis games, known for their awesome space backgrounds. A hidden place. My favorite Bjork song. Secret room. Here is a secret room. I forgot to get more shoes after I made my hilarious joke. Alright, so there's an extra life up there. So I could build a tower of letters to get that secret life or extra life, but now that I have the Aztec games unlocked, that's, you know, that would be a waste of time because I can just go back there over and over again. Okay, I remember something about leaving this level with a pile of letters spelling a word. I can't for the life of me remember what that is. Yep. Don't know. Maybe I'll look that up between episodes and show that off in like a final bonus video or something. Yeah, whatever it was, I definitely didn't figure it out as a kid. It's something that I had to look up years later. But, I'll take the word hiss with me and see if that takes me to a secret snake level. I could have taken the word moo and see if that takes me to a secret cow level. Interesting. So, letters beyond the first are worth more bonus points. Okay. Well, time to do the lighthouse proper. Wait, what were the initials that I found? It was MRC, right? Here is a secret room. Huh. Maybe I need to do MRC again. No, the solution can't be that simple. Could it? Okay, well, I don't have to do any of the extra bull honky now. I just need to not have that happen. I mean, if it does happen, it's fine. Thank you. Alright, it's quicker to just re-enter this level, grab some shoes, and leave the level, rather than going all the way back down. These stools are weirdly heavy. Like, you wouldn't think a wooden stool would have similar physics to like a 10-ton weight, but it kind of does. Okay. This probably isn't the solution, but I just want to try. So, the beach music again. Like, how come? There's so much better theme music, or there's so much better tracks they could have used. and like it doesn't really matter that it's not thematic. Like, it's not like the beach music is thematic to a secret room. I don't know. All right, C. R. Ah, crud. This room is actually a little easier to navigate when you don't have the shoes. Oh, if only this platform was like a fraction of an inch wider. I wouldn't be constantly falling back down. Alright, this is probably nothing. I'm not getting my hopes up that I solved a mystery. It's Mr. C, not Mr. E. Okay. Thought it was worth a try. Alright, got a pile of coins. Got a slot to put the coins in. Got a candle. Got some sort of tube. Oh, well, I see where the tube goes. Ah, we're at the top of the lighthouse. We have to light the giant candle. So, I'm guessing put a coin in the slot. Light the small candle, use it to light the big candle. Like, it's kind of weird that they give you so many coins and such a cavernous space to put them in. I mean, I guess if you mess up 5 times, it's good to it's good that they give you a margin of error. Oh, right. Candle, activate. Yay. Angel Tear Falls. Probably just going to be the music from Starfall Lake again. Yeah. Oh, there are fish in this waterfall. Surprise fish. Wait, do they hurt? No, okay, that's good. Alright, some more sneakers. We're sneaking. Bunch of seashells. Oh, hello. Are you here to trade items with me? Okay. Doesn't want a conch shell. You want an oyster shell, not that platform, this platform. Or maybe this is a clam. I don't know how to tell the difference between clams and oysters. Okay. Not interested. Can I jump off of the fish? I can. Excellent. Ah, I bet the friendly raccoon would like a nice green coin. Oh, I guess that was me jumping on a fish. What you got for me, buddy? Rubber duck. An orb. A knife. And then, will you just trade me back for the coin now? No, a key. Okay, so I have a knife and a key. I was thinking I should take the knife with me because there is a bridge with ropes I can cut. And that might be a thing. But there's also a key. And in my experience, keys typically open doors. Yeah, I don't know if you can even see these fish in the video. There might be like compression artifacts or something. I wish I could like hold down to see what's down there. Alright. A little... Oh. Oh, okay. So all of the pieces of the bridge just kind of fell into place in this other bridge. A statue of... Mars, the Roman god of war? I don't know. That's probably a character from another Psygnosis game. There's Psygnosis games that I haven't played because they're just sort of like more straightforward like action games. Like they released a game on the Megadrive called Shadow of the Beast, which I haven't played. Maybe that guy's from Shadow of the Beast. Maybe that game's cool, I don't know. I'm judging it unfairly because it just looked like kind of a standard side-scrolling beat-em-up. Alright, well, I think that was actually the solution to the level and not a way... Like, I'm not thinking there are any secrets on this level. I don't know, is Shadow of the Beast good? Let me know in the comments. And while you're at it, don't forget to like this video and ring that bell. Okay, we have a statue of a dude with what looks like a toupee and another toupee. So, if I know my video games, there will be a statue of a bald dude over here somewhere. Crud. Okay, that wasn't too bad. Got a pile of green apples. Possibly a Yellow Submarine reference. Although that might be a bit of a stretch. There was a Yellow Submarine enemy in a previous level, though. Yeah, the Beatles label was Apple Core Records, Core spelled C-O-R-P-S, period. So, a bit of a pun. Can I get these lined up a little better? And there was a scene in Yellow Submarine, well, a couple scenes, with a monster who generates an infinite number of big green apples. And uses them to bonk people. They're called bonkers. I don't know why. It is a mystery. Alright. Okay. This is going according to plan so far. Oh no! I joke about ringing the bell on YouTube because people always say that, but like if you want to know when I upload videos again, because like it's been sort of a long hiatus and I've had a few long hiatuses in my Let's Playography, but if you click the little bell icon next to the subscribe button, then you'll be notified when I start uploading again if I have another long hiatus. Not that I'm planning to, you see, but you know, sometimes stuff happens, computers break, The motivation leaves me sometimes, or sometimes I just want to focus on other projects. Sometimes I want to focus on writing or making games instead of playing them. And every time I come back after a long hiatus, there are people who are like, I had no idea you started recording again. And that's because YouTube doesn't show videos that haven't been blessed by the algorithm. But if you go to your subscribed page, which is youtube.com/, I forget if it's feed or feeds, I think it's feed, / subscriptions, then you just see a chronological list of everyone who, of the new videos from everyone that you're subscribed to. And let's see if that's enough. And that's what I always use. Like, I never use the YouTube front page because it always shows me a bunch of bull honky that I don't want to see. You know, I want to see a chronological list of videos from the people I'm subscribed to. So I recommend using the subscriptions page. Very most secret level that way. And just gave me a boatload of extra lives. So, another reason I was not concerned about extra lives. Like, I didn't remember the specific level, but I knew that there were levels that give you a ton of extra lives. But, in conclusion, either use the subscription page or ring the bell. Like, if you want to be notified when I upload videos, which, you know, maybe right now you don't want to be notified because I'm uploading on a fairly regular schedule, so you don't need to. But, you know, if you were wondering why you're not aware when I start making videos again, that's probably the reason. 5 lives. Nice. Alright, let's see what this very most secret level is all about. Lunar Jet Pug. I remember this. This is fun. So I'm pressing the jump button to fly around in my little Scooty Puff Jr. ship. It says XLS. I don't know what that stands for. So that can't be a hint for that other secret crud, because there was no X in there. It's here is a secret room. So I can grab that. I can shoot these little space invaders. I can try to shoot the space invaders. Or, I'm sorry, these are... Okay, I can't shoot them. They are Lunar Landers. The design of this level is a reference to the arcade game Lunar Lander, which is a very early vector game, which is why everything is kind of, stark lines against a black background. The title of this level is a reference to Lunar Jetman, which I don't think I knew about at the time. That's a Rare game by the company Rare, not Rare as in uncommon. Complete all 51 levels. I'll try. So I guess the gun is for blowing up these asteroids. I don't really know why I would want to do that. It sends me all the way back there. That's a bunch of crap. And there's also a game called Solar Jetman. and I don't know what that one is. Oh my goodness. Well, it's a good thing I just got 5 lives. So yeah, I wonder if this level is in the Megadrive version, and if so, what music it plays there. If they came up with, like, special music specifically for that level. And that's it. I don't know, maybe it gives you something if you defeat all the asteroids. I don't remember if I've ever actually been able to pull that off. I always end up taking a hit and dropping the gun. Like that. And then once the gun is dropped, you can't really get it again. I can hold down, maybe, and like fall through the gun. Ah. Alright, I might try to do that in like a special session, and if I'm able to pull it off, post the results. I wonder if I still have my shoes and stuff. Well, let's find out. Nope. I mean, it makes sense, because I died. You can't wear shoes and sunglasses in a spacecraft. You know, there are gravitational considerations and whatnot. Alright, well, that is the full path through the lighthouse. I might actually find all the secret levels and stuff. Well, I know that there are 51 levels, so at some point I can count and see how many I've actually finished. But that'll do it for today's episode. Thank you so much for watching. I had a tremendous time. I found some cool bonus levels, and I am excited to maybe finish the game tomorrow? I don't know. We'll find out. Goodbye.